have three layers of energy. I always start with a small story to speak about these three layers of energy, which has happened in my life. It's very fact. It's not even a story. It's a fact which I directly saw. I was staying in Himalayas at that time in a place called Mayavati. Anybody has been to Himalayas? Oh, so many are there in this group. That's nice. If you don't see Himalayas, really you miss one dimension of the life. It is not like other mountains. Never think that if you have seen the snow-capped mountains, if you have seen Himalayas, no. It is uncomparable. All over the world I am seeing everything. I am seeing tall mountains, snow-capped mountains, rivers, or forest, what not, everything I am seeing. But nothing compared to Himalayas. It is not even a physical grandeur, it is an energy. It is a totally different energy. If you have not seen Himalayas, really you miss one dimension of the life. One dimension of the planet Earth. You can say in a way, it's a spiritual capital of the whole world. I was staying there in a small ashram. Ashram means not like these built buildings, huts. Some 5-6 huts. In one night, one person can stay, like these huts. The beauty of that ashram is, every night, tigers will come. It's a tiger-haunted zone. One day, night, suddenly, we heard a tiger roaring sound. Elderly Swami shouted, "Hey, tiger is coming, all of you get into your room and lock your doors." Locking the door is no way help. Because, if a tiger gives one push, not only the door, even the wall will give way. Like these small, small huts. So he shouted, "Lock the door and support some stone so that the door doesn't open, gives way." All the Swamis, they locked their doors and supported some stone. Next day morning, in the daytime, tigers go away. I think they may be going for rest. Next day morning, that Swami came out and all of us came out to see how many are still alive. Everybody is out except one person. One person is missing. Immediately we rushed to his room. We wanted to just open the room and see. But the Swami shouted, "Hey, don't do that. Because there are many chances the tiger may be sitting inside. Would have gone from above after having a good dinner, maybe waiting for a breakfast to be served for room service. Waiting for room service. So you do not know. Don't go and open the door directly." Then immediately we started shouting, "Swamiji, Swami." From inside we heard the voice. Then we are comfortable that he is alive at least. He shouted, "Come inside and help me to come out." Then we just broke the window and entered inside. Inside we saw he kept a big stone to support the door. With all our 4 or 5 people, our efforts putting together, we just moved that stone, opened the door and brought him out. I asked him, "Swamiji, now 4 or 5 of us put together, with the help of crowbar only we could move that stone. How did you move that stone alone yesterday night?" You should hear his reply. He said, "What? I moved the stone. When I heard the tiger is coming, I simply lifted that stone." It's not a small stone, more than 200 kg stone. It is a stone with which they grind the wheat and the oil. which they grind, that stone, yeah, not 1 feet, 2 feet, more than 300 feet he has lifted the stone and walked. The moment he heard that a tiger is coming, he rushed to the kitchen. He saw this side, that side, he couldn't see anything. Only the wheat stone was there. He lifted the stone, rushed to his room, closed the door and supported the stone. And he says, really, I am not able to remember, Swamiji, how I brought that stone to my room. Suddenly today morning I saw that big stone is there in my room. I was shocked how this size stone is there. I did not even see the size in the night. I did not even see the size. Today morning I saw big stone is there inside my room, supporting the door. See, you need to understand one thing. The same man, he is able to lift the same stone night. But next day morning, he is not able to even move it. When the fear is there, when the emergency to safeguard or to guard his life, anything can be done. If you see that stone, then only you will understand what I say really. It's not a small stone, the at least 200 kg. To make roti, they will grind wheat and the oil. Any of you have seen that type of stones?
Yeah.
In the North India they use. In South India they will grind the rice they use.
It's called a chakki.
Chakki. Yes. Whatever its name, I don't know. But such big stone, you will be shocked. I was really shocked to see that stone, how he lifted or how he handled. And even 1 feet, 2 feet, you can understand. 300 feet he has walked with that stone. Carrying that stone, he walked 300 feet, went to the room and supported the door with that stone. From this incident, you can understand, you have special energy which is used only at the time of emergency. The first layer of energy is the energy which you use for your day-to-day activity from morning till night. By the time it is 8 o'clock, you are out. Nothing more. When anybody asks anything, you only get irritated. You just shout at them or jump on them. Second layer is emergency layer. Layer of energy which you use only at the time of emergency. Third layer of energy is the energy which is spiritual energy. At the time of spiritual experiences, what energy you feel. And the energy with which they do all miracles. The spiritual people do miracles. This is the third layer of energy. Third layer of energy only is called as God, Paramatman, universal energy or existence. Once you know how to connect yourself with the third layer of energy, you are enlightened. That's all. Enlightenment is nothing else. Don't think enlightened means to be gone will come. No. We have weird ideas about enlightenment. Enlightenment means they will, as if they will fly on the earth. Enlightenment is nothing but having access to the third layer of energy. When you can enter into the third layer of energy, any time by your will, that is what is enlightenment.
What was the second
point? Emergency adrenal layer. First layer is not adrenal layer.
No.
Who said adrenal layer?
You know, second layer, actually what you are saying, I think I belong to, that when we can do, when under fear and when emergencies come, adrenaline, there is one, like you were talking yesterday, chemical changes take place. Adrenaline is one of the chemicals which is pumped in, and that prepares us for fight or flight experiences.
But you say only neurologically, it's only very small dimension what happens at that time.
Yeah,
it's like you are seeing the top of the iceberg, but what ice mountain is inside, you do not know. Because second layer does miracles.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. People pick up those trucks and all that, and under the truck you are there. And all of a sudden you get the energy, you can just do wonders.
The emergency layer not only opens at the time of fear, it opens at the time of greed also. That is why any fool who falls in love writes, becomes a poet. Start writing poetry. And only fools fall in love, that is different.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear the first layer.
Day-to-day layer.
What?
First layer is the energy which you use for everyday activity, day-to-day activity. The third layer of energy only is called as God or the divine. All these three layers of energy meet and merge in Vishuddhi Chakra, throat center. Throat center is the doorway or the gateway to all these three layers of energy. You can access to all these three layers of energy through Vishuddhi. You should understand one thing. The three layers of energy is always available to you, continuously. Only we don't use it by and by because we never used. We forgot that we have three layers of energy. Small example. Have you seen the boat jetty? What you call here? Pier. Where you stop the boats? Pier. In India, we call boat jetties. In the ocean, the bank of ocean, in the harbors, they will build a small wall so that safely they can stop the, they can keep the boats. A portion of the ocean will be separated by walls so that they can make the boat stand. Same way, you have also separated a portion of your being for your day-to-day activities. If the whole ocean is directly available, it is difficult to control the boats. That is why to anchor the boats, you make a small place. If the whole three layers of energy is available to the body, it is difficult to handle the body. It will be going to the two peak and two low energies. So to keep the body in a normal condition, you build a boat jetty. That boat jetty is only called mind or ego. Mind is the boat jetty you build. By and by, you never travel into the ocean. For a long time, you never visited the ocean. You stay only in the harbor. By and by, staying only in the harbor, you forget ocean belongs to you and you belong to ocean. That is the same thing happens to you. You are already God, you are third layer energy, but for the sake of convenience, you built few walls around you to keep your body intact. So by and by, you stop traveling into the ocean. You stop traveling into the third layer energy. Because you have not traveled into the third layer energy for a long time, you forgot that there is something called third layer energy at all. It's like you come and settle here 30 years before. 30 years you are here. By and by, if you don't speak your mother tongue, you forget. It's not that it is lost, you forget. Suddenly somebody speaks, Bagunara. Then immediately, whole thing comes back. You remember the whole thing. Just like that. You are God. You are connected to third layer energy. But by and by, because you, for a long time, you are not used, you are not accessed to it, it is lost. Now, if you see a master who handles, who lives with all the three layers of energy, suddenly you also remember. When I speak to you in the language of energy, you remember. That is what happens when you see a master. When you see a person who speaks in your mother tongue, you remember the mother tongue. Same way when you speak, when you see a person who remembers, who speaks in your, see, mother tongue is the verbal mother tongue. Energy language is the mother language of body, body language of, how to explain, you understand this way. Mother tongue means the verbal language. Same way, there's one more thing we have to call a new word, mother body language. Mother verbal language is your mother tongue, mother body language. The third layer energy is your mother body language, is your nature.
Is it the body or the being?
Being, body language is nothing but being. Verbal language only is verbal. Body language is actually total being. Your total being only will be expressed in your body language. Face is the index of the mind. And body is the whole book of the mind, that's all. That is why we cover it with cloth. And not only, it is the expression of whole being. Your whole being is nothing but your body. Mother body language is your nature, your third layer of energy. When somebody speaks in your mother verbal language, you remember it. Same way, when a master speaks to you in the mother's body language, you remember it. That is what the master's presence actually does.